The Federal Reserve has taken a big step by this week in lowering interest rates. That'll have a huge immediate effect on the economy. But having said that, we need to act within the next 30 days. Second, we don't need to put in place an economic stimulus package that's going to be in place forever. Maybe for the next 12 months would be appropriate. And targeted, let's try to target it to the parts of our economy in this country, the places where unemployment is 10%, where people really are struggling, where home foreclosures are just skyrocketing. It should be targeted to those areas. Our troops continue to perform with great efficiency, and with great courage. They're doing their job. The folks who aren't doing their job are the Iraqi political leaders, because they've been unwilling, at least to this point in time, to do the tough things that they need to be able to do to get people to bond together and to join together, Sunnis, Shiites, and the Kurds. They need to figure out how to share their oil wealth. They need to figure out how to provide the opportunity for provincial elections, for local elections. They need to finish the work that they started on their constitution to give equal rights to a whole broad cross-section of people. And if they will do those things, if they make those tough decisions, then there will be a reconciliation. And with that reconciliation will grow the ability of the Iraqis to defend themselves, provide for their own security, and we can expedite our withdrawal and redeployment. The conventional wisdom around Washington is that we're not going to pass a climate change or a global warming bill this year with the Republican president on his last term and Democratic majority in the Congress. I still think we can get something done. I think we can get something meaningfully done that will reduce the threat that global warming poses to our nation and to our planet. We can do it in a way that does not cripple the economy, that does not make us less competitive, but more competitive. And what it requires is us all to do our very, very best efforts in that regard. We have a good, strong bill coming out of the Senate Environmental Committee. I want to add to that bill to reduce emissions of mercury, of sulfur dioxide and nitrogen oxide, which have a huge and adverse health impact on us, particularly on the East Coast. So I want to do the climate change, but I also want to do the health, address the health consequences for three other major pollutants.